He just crosses the road, someone makes a Lee right turn, hits him, runs him over, kills him, and his mother cries over his dead body. And that's how the movie ends.
La Misma Luna, presented by me.
We went from 8 to 17 subscribers. Thank you for turning me up. Now enjoy the video. The movie begins with this MILF named Rosario.
That is fucking disgusting.
She's a Mexican immigrant who came to the United States through nefarious wetback means, if you know what I mean. Every Sunday, she goes to a payphone to call her son that still lives in Mexico named Carlitos. He was in my last movie summary, Innocent Voices. His name was Chile. He was Chavo's friend. He got blicked. Yeah, that was him. And now he got his own solo movie! Okay, Chile, I see you doing big things, making big career moves. I see you, my nigga, I love to see it. I wanna see more of it. Carlitos lives with his grandmother, and after taking care of his grandmother, he goes to work for this woman named Don Carmen. Don Carmen's the plug. She be making fake ID cards and helping immigrants sneak across to the US. Ugly Betty's in the movie. She plays a coyote. She offers to help Don Carmen sneak immigrants to the US, but Don Carmen ain't going. She says that Ugly Betty's too pussy and La Mira will be able to spot them from a mile away. Before she leaves, she gives Carlitos her card and tells him if she changes her mind to call her. The next morning, when Carlitos wakes up from bed, he goes to check on his sick grandmother and realizes she died in her sleep. With his granny gone and no one left to take care of him, Carlitos decides to sneak over to the US and reunite with his mother. Carlitos goes to Ugly Betty and asks her to help him sneak across the border. And if you're wondering why Carlitos went to Ugly Betty and not the plug Don Carmen, it's because Don Carmen constantly refuses to help Carlitos sneak across the border. She says it's too dangerous for a child that young, and she's kind of right. So he has to resort to boofy-ass Ugly Betty. Ugly Betty gets to the checkpoint and immediately gets racially profiled. La Mira starts searching her van. And this is the worst search ever, bro. This nigga does a whole lot of nothing. Bro, all he does is pull out the pooper scooper and search under the car and check the floorboards. That's it. That's all he does.
Gotcha,
he's not gonna check this super conspicuous blanket that was intentionally put over the back seat to hide an immigrant. This nigga's retarded. He needs to get fired. He is the sole reason why we got all these illegal immigrants in the US. The immigration finishes their search and lets Ugly Betty go. It turns out that Ugly Betty has over $700 of unpaid parking tickets. So the immigration officers impound her car. All you had to do was pay your parking tickets, Betty. Carlitos escapes the impound lot and goes to the bus stop. He tries to buy a bus ticket to LA, but the old lady at the counter won't sell him one because he's not accompanied with an adult. He sees the police and decides to hide in a bathroom. While in the bathroom, he meets this registered sex offender.
Don't like cops? Me neither.
Aw, hell no. Carlitos asks the registered sex offender to buy him a bus ticket to LA. The registered sex offender agrees. But when Carlitos tries to give him the money for the bus ticket, he realizes that he dropped his money at the impound lot. Carlitos asks the registered sex offender to take him to the impound lot so he can get his money. At first, the sex offender isn't going for it, but then Carlitos offers him $100 and he agrees, which is kind of skeptical. Like, why are you doing shit for $100? Like, don't you have a stable job that pays you a lot more than that? Of course you don't, because you're a sex offender and you're probably homeless. The sex offender drives to the impound lot. While at the impound lot, Carlitos finds out that the two coyotes came back for their van. Carlitos tells the sex offender that he can't pay him his money. The sex offender gets angry and kidnaps Carlitos. Oh, hell nah. Luckily, the sex offender doesn't sex offend Carlitos. Instead, he tries to sell Carlitos to this shady Mexican guy.
No.
Oh. Why would you want to buy a kid? I never got that. Like, why buy a kid? Like, what's he gonna do for you? You on some weird human trafficking Andrew Tate shit, bro. Ah,
somebody help me!
A good Samaritan named Rena sees the deal go down and tries to stop it. Let him go! She successfully stops the deal and prevents Andrew Tate face ass from human trafficking Carlitos. Rena takes Carlitos home where she houses many other illegal immigrants. Or is it just me, or did we all know that one Mexican nigga that looked exactly like this? Carlitos, Rena, and all the other illegal immigrants have dinner together. They're all laughing, bonding, watching One Piece, having a grand time. The next day, Carlitos goes to work with his illegal immigrant friends. He's working at this tomato garden until it gets raided by La Mira.
Oh shit!
Stop in the name of the law.
Hey! Oh shit!
Under arrest. Most of the immigrants get arrested, and the people Carlitos came with leave them behind. After the raid, the only people left on the tomato farm are Carlitos and this one grumpy ass immigrant nigga. The grumpy ass immigrant nigga tries to ditch Carlitos, but he follows him. The pair walks down the road trying to hitch a ride. The grumpy ass immigrant nigga flags down a car. He tries to ditch Carlitos for a second time, but Carlitos hops in the car with him.
Another one.
The Mexicans that picked them up are in a band and they play a song for Carlitos. And I'm not gonna lie, these niggas were spitting. The band of Mexicans drop off the pair in Tucson, Arizona. While in Arizona, Enrique tells Carlitos to get the fuck on and stop following them. As soon as Carlitos gets the fuck on, he's about to get robbed by these group of thugs.
I'm in danger!
Enrique saves him by posing as his father. Enrique offers to take Carlitos to the police station so they can send him back to Mexico safely. But Carlitos ain't going! He's determined to get to LA to see his mother again. Enrique asks Carlitos how he plans on getting to LA. Carlitos says he'll find work and save up enough money to buy bus fare. And Enrique hits him with,
"No one in this town will hire you."
Oh yeah?
Carlitos is able to find a job for him and Enrique. While working together, Enrique and Carlitos develop a friendship. After their shift, Carlitos tells Enrique about his father that he never met. He tells Enrique that he lives in Tucson. Enrique asks Carlitos if he wants to meet his father, and Carlitos is kinda iffy about it. However, the next morning, Carlitos decides to meet his father for the first time. Carlitos asks his father to take him to LA to reunite with his mother. His father agrees to take him to LA, but he never shows up to pick up Carlitos. Carlitos storms outside angrily and takes out his frustration.
You jammed it, bruh! You jammed it!
Fatherless child.
Enrique goes outside to calm Carlitos down.
My nigga, chill.
And steps in to take him to LA. The duo arrive in Los Angeles. The duo starts looking for the payphone. Carlitos' mom calls him on. Since Carlitos doesn't know her address, the pair search all day, but they're not able to find the payphone, so they sleep on a park bench for the night. Enrique wakes up early in the morning and buys donuts for Carlitos. While he was gone, a pair of cops saw Carlitos sleeping on a park bench. At first, Enrique was about to abandon Carlitos.
I don't know you!
But he changes his mind and decides to save Carlitos. Enrique distracts the cop and allows Carlitos to escape. Enrique gets arrested.
You're under arrest.
Free broski.
Free broski. Free broski. Free broski. Free broski.
Carlitos runs away from the scene. While running away, he sees his mother from across the street. The two wait for traffic to die down so they can reunite with each other. The movie ends with the walk sign. Yeah, that's how the movie ends. We don't get to see them embrace at all. It's fucking retarded. This movie was fucking mid, bro. Don't get me wrong, I like the movie genuinely, but there's just so many fucking things that irk me about it, bro. There's so many cop-outs, there's so many Deus Ex Machina plot points. The characters are really bland, and watching it more than once was a mission. To be completely honest, the only reason I covered this movie is because it had Chele from Innocent Voices, and I fucking love Innocent Voices, so I decided to give this movie a chance. And I thought it was funny that Innocent Voices and this movie both had MILFs, and I want to be like a back-to-back MILF movie. You know, like a MILF-a-thon? I don't know. I just like the MILFs. Favorite character had to have been Enrique. He had the most character development out of any character. Honestly, he had the only character development throughout the entire movie. In the beginning of the movie, he starts off as a lame-ass nigga, and by the end, he's a real-ass fucking nigga! He starts off trying to ditch Carlitos by the side of the highway, and by the end of the movie, he sacrifices himself to save Carlitos. And I just thought that was really, really beautiful, especially the smile on his face in the back of the cop car. It really shows that he has no regrets doing what he did. Least favorite character is Carlitos' dad. I fucking hate Carlitos' dad. He's a fucking loser, deadbeat, bum, scrub. And honestly, it's not even the fact that he abandons Carlitos. Like, it's not even that. It's just like the small shit he does in the movie. It's like it's set up for you not to like him. Like, this dude really criticized Carlitos' mom for living in LA for 4 years when he's never even met his fucking son. That was their first time of them meeting each other. And he has the audacity to criticize Rosario for leaving for 4 years to seek a better life for her son. And when she practically raised him alone for 5 years. Get the fuck out of here, bro. You fucking deadbeat loser dickhead. He really looked his son in his fucking eyes and lied straight to his face. Like, I don't know how you call yourself a man after that. After 9 years, your son asked you for one thing and you can't stick it through for him? And you're gonna deceive him knowing damn well you're not gonna come pick him up to help him reunite with his mother? You are the definition, the textbook Webster encyclopedia definition of a fucking deadbeat dad. Favorite scene was Enrique's sacrifice. I fucking love this scene. It really brings Enrique's character development all the way together. The only thing I don't like about this scene is Enrique getting arrested. That was really hard to watch. I wish he would have like swerved them cops, you know what I mean? But it is what it is. Free Enrique to his backwards. Free that man. He ain't do nothing. Also, while I'm freeing people free Young Thug free, I gotta wear a lot of bodies for YSL and send all the opposition to hell. Also, free Andrew Tate, even though he's a sex trafficker, that nigga funny as fuck, hilarious. He need to be out of jail and making TikToks making me laugh. Least favorite scene was the ending. It was so stupid. I don't know why they made it so ambiguous. It made no sense whatsoever, and it was a terrible creative decision. Like, in my head, I always imagine that Carlitos get hit by a car. Like, he just crosses the road, someone makes a Lee right turn, hits him, runs him over, kills him, and his mother cries over his dead body. And that's how the movie ends. Like, this whole movie, this whole journey was about a mother and a son reuniting, and we don't get to see them reunite. What the fuck? I was so disappointed when I seen this ending. You will not believe, bro. You will not understand, bro. That's it. Thank you if you watched to the end. Make sure you comment down below. Who's your favorite character? Who's your least favorite character? What's your favorite scene? What's your least favorite scene? I got a lot more videos on the way. Just you wait. Just you wait. But until then, I will see you next time. Peace.